When did you become a leader?
I was a leader from fairly early in life, in terms of offering ideas to people, my siblings, and so on. And then I went to school, and I would not be able to give it a date, but I knew that I was a leader when I was very young. My father was a politician. He had been a politician from when I was a youth. And so I grew up in a political family. And my father ended up being one of the first African elected members of then LEGICO, which is now Parliament. And later on became the first vice president of the Republic of Kenya. So he would not be, against me going into politics. But he did not want me to go in politics with him together, because he said that politics was very risky. So he would have preferred that I remain in business.
Mr. Prime Minister, you inspire a lot of us. Who is your role model?
I was very much inspired by John Kennedy. First, his courage and his foresight. He is the one who challenged the American youth. Ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country. I also believed in Nelson Mandela, near home.
You're a very influential person to the Kenyan people. What is the secret behind your ability to influence Kenyans?
There is what you call trust. People will trust you if you're consistent with whatever you're saying and what you're doing. If you do what you say, then people will develop trust around you. They'll say that, oh, if it is so-and-so who has said it, then it must be right. So consistency, honesty, faithfulness is what the people like.
Mr. Prime Minister, what was your ambition that drove you to the line of leadership, that you have become today the Prime Minister of the Republic of Kenya and an influencing leader in the African continent?
Well, it is about commitment to a certain ideals that you aspire for, and trying to achieve those ideals, working together with other people. Because you cannot be a leader if you do not know the interests and ambitions of your people. So a leader is somebody who champions the aspirations of the people that he leads. Therefore, you must first have also a clear vision of what you want to do, what you want to achieve, and then work towards that achievement and influencing other people to help you in pursuit of that ambition.
Mr. Prime Minister, during your lifetime, you have achieved an ambition that you have pursued for the last 20 years. The reward is a new republic, a new constitutional dispensation, and more significantly, a vision for the future as embodied in Vision 2030. What is the next ambition?
When we came into government, first in 2003, we came up with this idea of a clear vision. And then we coined the Vision 2030. 78% of our population below 35. And between 15 to 30 are nearly 12 million. It's about 32% of our population. That population must be empowered to be able to benefit from it. So we are talking about quality from nursery to primary. Then we are concerned about the transition rate from primary to secondary. And again, from transition from secondary to tertiary colleges and university. In the other pillar, you see, we are putting up a lot of emphasis on infrastructure development, because this is a route to economic takeoff. All this will provide a lot of employment to the young people who are coming up. But they can only gain from those employment if they have got the skills. And this is a challenge to the youth generally. That, the youth have a role to play. The government has a role to empower the youth. And once empowered, the youth themselves have to take advantage of this opportunity. For example, as they are studying, they need to work hard and excel in their education so that they can qualify. And once they qualify, then they will join the mainstream Kenyan society.